Okay, so this is the first time that I'm doing it, on camera at least. I hope it will be fun. New video coming right up. Thanks for tuning in, my name is Angelos and this is my perfume vlog. I'm a Greek fragrance enthusiast, aka Greek perfume aficionado. And of course, if you are new to this channel or you enjoy what you see, please consider subscribing and turn on the post notifications in order to stay up to date with any future upload. So as I was saying, this is the first time I'm doing it, at least on camera. You probably know that I'm usually against blind buying a perfume, but this time, I mean, I was so intrigued. I was recommended this fragrance by a very good friend of mine, a dear friend of mine, and he told me that this is a little bit challenging, so I couldn't resist. I just pulled the trigger and voila. So here it is. I haven't opened it. It's from a well-known retailer, let's say, with great discounts, and I'm opening it. I know it's a little bit of a mystery because I didn't mention it, the title or something like that. So okay, we have a barcode or something here, and here is bubble wrapped, and let's see, did I mess up with the box? I think not. Okay, so It's bubble wrapped. It's wrapped with plastic and cellophane again. I have to open it again. So it's a Mukhallat Al Shams. I hope I'm not butchering this name. It's from the house of AJMAL. And it's a fragrance that many people talk about. Usually that they describe it as a very challenging fragrance, a very animalic, let's say, fragrance. But we'll see together. I mean, it's totally new for me. It's a blind buy, I told you. I never smelled it. I was just recommended this fragrance. And yes, I mean, I don't need to say much stuff about the presentation, I guess. The box. And here you go. Mukhallat Al Shams. And here is the bottle. I mean, many details. For me, it's a very signature Middle Eastern bottle of perfume. I mean, it screams Middle Eastern for me. Let's go. I am just pulling up the sleeves because I don't want to smell weird if it's weird. Oh no, it's totally... Wow, it's totally okay, to be honest. Yes, I'm impressed. I mean, I will spray a little bit more. Okay, so first impressions. I mean, it's not that strong. I thought it was super strong. It's okay, it's strong. You get a little bit of this cheesy, a little bit fungal smell from wood. The real wood oil. I don't know if it's real wood oil here. I mean, I forgot to mention that this was a blind buy because it costed me only 50 euros totally with shipping and cash on delivery. Otherwise I wouldn't pull the trigger, of course. And yes, I mean, you get this wood opening, the wood feeling, the usually aged wood from either Cambodia or Malaysia or Indonesia. So initially you get this feeling, the little bit so-called animalic wood, but I don't find it quite animalic, to be honest. And then it's weird, it's a little bit woody. Not a little bit, actually it's very woody. Okay. Some musk, definitely musk here, and wow, I mean, I like it. I like it, to be honest, and I don't believe it's very hard to wear or difficult to wear to apply. I mean, I don't see someone wearing this fragrance in an office, for example, because many people might be a little bit offended by this intense woody and a little bit cheesy fungal, I told you, animalic smell of wood. But it turns a little bit softer right now. I don't know if they changed anything in this fragrance because I was told it was like super strong. I mean, don't get me wrong, it's strong, but I don't know. To me, at least, it's very wearable. It's very wearable. I mean, I would easily wear it, and not only during winter time. Let's say, sometimes we usually say winter time, it's for very bold and strong fragrances. I would easily wear it during springtime, for a nighttime, for example, whenever this COVID ends and we can do some proper night outs. Yes, I'm impressed. Actually, I will definitely wear this fragrance. I mean, it's totally okay. I don't smell lots of, let's say, prominent floral notes like rose or jasmine. I mean, there is a floral bouquet, probably leaning more to, let's say, white florals and a little bit of rose. Now I get very musky feeling, to be honest. I mean, this wood first impression, you get hit by this wood in the initial spray. I mean, this a little bit is fading away, in my opinion. I don't smell it, I don't detect it. Quite, let's say, it's not quite prominent, but yes, I mean, for the price, actually, for yes, the structure and wow. I mean, I can, this is not a review, I'm not reviewing this fragrance because I just smelled it, it's impossible to review a fragrance just smelling it, but yes, it's just my initial thoughts, for example, my initial impressions, and I'm quite impressed. I mean, for the price as well, I told you, it's total for 50 ml, yes, it's 50 ml Eau de Parfum, and it's 50 euros with, I mean, all included, the shipping costs, I told you I paid cash on delivery, so yes, 50 euros, I mean, you can't get such quality with 50 euros, and now it's a little bit more floral, now I smell a little bit more some rosy aspects. I mean, you don't get jasmine or other very characteristic notes, floral notes. I'm impressed, to be honest, and I never recommend a blind buy. I don't know if you can try this fragrance, but I mean, for the price you're paying and what you're getting, at least as for now, I'm very impressed. Very impressed. And it keeps going. I mean, it has this woody, I told you the wood aspect is a little bit toned down. Totally wearable, in my opinion. I mean, I was expecting something like a monster or something. I mean, it's totally cool. Totally cool in my book, and yes, why not? I mean, I don't know if I review it on my channel or I definitely see wearing this during winter time. So you will probably see this again. I mean, probably in one of my lists for winter, why not? Okay, sorry, I keep smelling my arm here, but it's impossible because it's the first time I'm smelling it, and I'm quite impressed with the quality, to be honest, and the blend. I mean, wow. So, I don't know, if you can get your hands on this fragrance, sorry for any fingerprints or stains here, sorry, I just opened it, so just take a look once again at the bottle. And yes, I mean, some details here. The cap is weird. You see the cap is a little bit odd. Let's spray one more before I end this video. Two more. Probably this will stay for 1 week on my hand because I don't know. I was expecting something very intense, but this is really cool. I mean, I don't know, if you are feeling like blind buying something, I hate myself for saying something like that, but feel free. I mean, the price is okay, the blend is fantastic. If you like this intense woody, a little bit floral and musky, but I told you it's not a review, it's just what I initially get from this fragrance, yes. So, till the next one, cheers!